Today, I'm going to show you how to use gradient textures to get nice, ultralight lighting on low-poly models. I first encountered this process in detail when I saw a series of posts by @SeñorJueves3D on Twitter, who made this amazing art and has written a paper on gradient texturing using extremely small textures, which lays out this process extremely well. Links to their Twitter, ArtStation, and paper are in the description.
The gradient atlas texturing method.
Here's a very simple example of how this method works. I'll take you through it step by step. Let's add a plain old UV sphere and move it to the left, then add a cube, move it to the right, add a bevel modifier set to 0.05, then apply the modifier. Let's quickly unwrap our cube by selecting it, going into edit mode, navigating to the select menu, and choosing Select Sharp Edges. Then we'll hit U to bring up the UV menu and select Mark Seam. Let's go back into Object Mode and switch to Material Preview Mode. Next, we want to use a gradient texture as our material. A gradient texture is just an image with some colored gradients on it. To use a gradient texture on our models, we need to use an image texture as our base color. To set that up, all we do is add a new material, give it a name, click the yellow dot next to Base Color, select Image Texture from the list, then click Open and select your gradient texture from wherever it is on your PC. Now, if we go to the UV Editing workspace, in order to make the texture visible in the UV workspace, just select it from the drop-down menu right here. We can see our gradient texture and the UVs, but the UVs aren't oriented correctly for what we want to do. To get the desired lighting effect, we want the bottom parts of our object to be in the dark part of the gradient, and the top parts in the light part of our gradient. To achieve that effect, go either into front, left, or right orthographic view in NumPad 1 or 3, either will work, then go into edit mode, then hit A to select all, followed by U to bring up the UV menu, and then we select Project from View. This will take our camera view and use it to place the object's UVs along our texture in the same orientation as our viewport. And now, if I take my cube and I scale it along the y-axis in the UV space, you'll see that it stretches out along the gradient. And voila, the light part is up top and the darker part is on the bottom. And yes, the UVs will look really weird because they're very stretched, and normally maybe that's not ideal, but in this case, that's exactly what we want, because it allows us to control the apparent lighting on the object. If we select our UVs and move them around, you can see the effect it's having. Lengthening your UVs has the effect of intensifying the gradient, while shortening them has the effect of softening it. Now, the reason we put a single small bevel onto our cube's edges is so that we can simulate edge highlights. Let's select our cube, go into edit mode, select all of the large faces, then hit Ctrl-I to invert our selection. This will allow us to quickly select all of our beveled edges. Then, in the UV window, we can use the G key to grab and move those selected faces on the Y-axis to make them lighter. If you need more room, you can always scale down your UV size, like so, and adjust from there. From here, you can tweak and stretch the UV faces along the gradient to get the desired effect. Now, this is where it gets really interesting. Here are two identical models, using identical gradient textures, but one of the textures is 2048 by 2048, and the other is 64 by 64. Take a moment to see if you can tell which is which. Here, I'll even spin around so you can see the whole thing. Could you separate the high and low res textures? Well, if you picked 64 by 64 on the right, you were correct, and you have pretty sharp eyes, because they look very, very similar. They look similar enough, in fact, that from the range you would see it at in a game, it really doesn't matter. And generally speaking, the more performant option is the better option. So a 2048kb texture versus a 64kb texture? The choice is pretty simple. The 64x64 texture is 32 times smaller than the other texture, and therefore will take up a crazy, crazy smaller amount less memory than the bigger texture. To bring this point home even further, let's look at the two textures in the UV workspace. This is the 2K texture for the model on the left. This is the 64x64 texture for the model on the right. Yeah, that's the difference in size. It's insane. If I zoom way, way, way in, you can see that it's the exact same texture, just reduced by a factor of 32, and yet the visual fidelity is nearly identical. So why is this process useful? We can answer that with Senor Cuevas' article. I hope I'm saying that right. The TLDR is that textures take up way more memory than geometry does, and you can save a tremendous amount on performance by reducing texture sizes a ton. In order to make the best use of these tiny textures, we want as much lighting information baked in as we can get, and that's where gradient texturing comes in. It's an efficient, effective, and fun way to texture simple models. I also want to shout out some other creators that I learned this method from who cover the process in great detail. First, I recommend Infenzia, who makes amazing Blender and game dev content and is an expert at this texturing method as well as low poly modeling. There are links to his channel in the description. Another good tutorial comes from LMH Poly, and it covers this exact process in detail by showing you how to create a low poly scene in Blender. Links to that video also in the description. So let's go over the process one more time to simplify it. Step 1, create your simple model. Step 2, go to the UV editing workspace. Step 3, unwrap your model, usually simply selecting sharp edges, then unwrapping will suffice, since our geo is very simple. Step 4, go into front or side orthographic view using numpad 1 or 3. Step 5, hit A to select all, then hit U and select project from view. This will orient the UVs on the texture to match your viewport orientation. The final step is select, move, rotate, and scale your UVs to the desired color, and you're done. Thank you to @SeñorJueves3D for sharing this method in such amazing detail. It is a really awesome method, and I appreciate you doing that. If this video helped you out or you learned something new, smash the like button and subscribe for more. It's a great way to support this channel and help me make more content. To my Deuces Club members out there who have been waiting so long for a video, I thank you for your patience. This one was a long time coming, and there will be more coming soon. And as always, thank you to my amazing patrons, without whom I couldn't make these videos. Thank you to Bread News Bears, Comet Lord Miniatures, Loki, CD, Animistan, Paul Webb, Riley Brown, Victoria Carrillo, C. Unger, and Pi Brown. Thank you all so much. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Deuces.